Welcome back, OPL fans, to Week 8, day number 2 of the Oceanic Pro League. We just witnessed Sin take down Avant in a very long and extended game in their first best of 3 series, really off the back of Ryan Meister. But before we break down that game a little bit more, let's take a look at the social contest that we have for you guys out at home. We want you to tell us who is your favorite player and why. Tweet your entries with the hashtag IMOPL, telling us who is your favorite player in the OPL and why they are your favorite player. You know, we've got Teagan on the desk here today. He might be your favorite player in the Oceanic Pro League. You know, top 8 entries do win a mystery skin as well, so that's a pretty cool thing.
Can I tweet that I'm my own favorite player? I want a mystery skin. If I get a blitz skin.
Well, if it's created, I don't see why not. But, you know, let's kind of break down that game a little bit more, because it really felt like the first match between Sin and Avant was very heavily focused between the mid-jungle duo coming up from Avant and Sin, respectively.
Yeah, and I mean, we said it best at the end. Rhymeister carried it, and we didn't get to talk about them before, but Sin seemed to do this, and I think Raz will agree. They put a lot of pressure on Rhymeister to carry, but he handles it well.
Mm-hmm. Every single time he gets the ball, put it on the court. And before, I guess, like, talking about, like, their old, like, synergy that they had, because they always had, like, chippies to kind of at least have the, like, at least a little bit of a dynamic, right? They can put it on one basket or another. Now it's all on Rhymeister's shoulder, and he's doing well. He can carry that pressure, like, pretty decently.
Mm-hmm. Especially because he has a lot of good synergy with Jews. Mm. People really rag on Jews. They say, oh, he's not that good. He's a poor player, right? And that might be true. That might not be true. Doesn't matter. In competitive, he links up with his team really well. He commands them really well. And I think while they do put a lot of pressure on Rhymeister, they work around that really well. They get him all of these opportunities to do what he does best in carrying games.
Yeah, exactly. And so actually one thing I really want to talk about too was that, yeah, Sin always has that teamwork and the synergy that works for them, and that maybe they can carry out a game with that. Mm-hmm. But Avant, like, they were, like, I think one point I was talking about is that if they work as a team, they can really bring it together, right? Because they have a lot of solo queue minds and all that nonsense. But they really did bring it together. Regardless, like, I know it must feel bad for them. Like, it must really feel bad.
They just got to take the positives, you know? They controlled half of that game very, very well until it all fell apart at Baron. But, I mean, teams do that all the time, right?
Yeah. Well, all the time, actually.
Well, speaking of Avant playing really well as a team there, you know, they played that map quite well and had lots of control, like you said, Teagan. It was off the back of a lot of great vision control they had around the 10, 11-minute mark of that match. What kind of fell apart from them? What did they really need to change coming in the second game? Because was it just those Baron throws? Is there anything else they really need to work on?
I mean, if it was up to me, I just tighten up the Baron calls. Mm-hmm. And I mean, I get to say that, and I never make Baron calls. I put it all on Seb. So Seb, thank you for making my job easy. but that seems to be their big problem, you know? 10 to 20 minutes. If you look at the replay, look at the map. They had 5 pings out. They had control of both sides of the map.
Yeah.
Vision everywhere, no matter what. And they seem to utilize it. They got into good positions for Baron, and then they just sort of threw it away. Maybe, I mean, I hate saying don't go to Baron. I know you said this before. You hate seeing people get really, really worried about attempting it.
Yeah.
But maybe exert more control over Dragon, especially if at the time of the game where they trade Elder Dragon for Baron, they could have had 4 Dragons if they just exerted control over there. Mm-hmm. Then Elder Dragon's a better trade. But instead, Baron was better.
Well, we'll have to see if they can take advantage of that coming into this next game, if Avant can clean up the game. For now, though, we're going to go throw it back over towards the caster there for Rusty and Atlas.
Thank you very much, Fish. And I really did like the cute little Dignitas plug there, because, you know, Baron was a bit of a problem for both of these teams towards the end of that first game.
It definitely was. I think at one point AV decided they wanted the Elder Dragon instead of the Baron, but one of the few decisions that AV did make poorly, and there was only a couple of them really in that game, and that was the determining factor, of course. They got to late game, both teams were scaled, just that one, at the end of the day, actually hit that execution better.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And AV, we'll see what they change moving into this one. Of course, probably not as much, but we'll see whether the Cassiopeia still receives as much prevalence as AV Banaway Rise first here on the blue side of the map.
Yeah, I was actually hoping that teams would actually focus Squiggle one time. He's shown that he's a good Shen player, and Shen's starting to see bans, but Nautilus is his other go-to.
Yeah.
Why not take away two of those, get rid of one strong champion with it, especially on blue side, which was my expectation for AV. Instead, we'll see where they go from here, but with that Rise ban, it's unlikely.
Shen probably will be banned away. We'll see whether the Nautilus is in there as well, as Thresh is hit by Rogue.
But it's
definitely
the same principle.
A huge power pick, exactly, yeah.
So instead of taking away the Nautilus from Squiggle, they get rid of the same thing that's been working for Rogue. Rogue does have a lot of champions, though, which is why I said maybe Squiggle's a better option. They're kind of bottlenecking themselves with that ban phase and giving Sin what they want.
Taking away that bottom lane completely here. Sin now looking at a final ban, but no Shen ban to come in here from Sin, as we'll see whether Paradise decides to take that one away, but it just doesn't feel like a Paradise champion necessarily, as Karma is going to hit the bench. So Jake not going to be able to grab that one. Of course, big fan of things like Nami as well, is Jake definitely a very versatile player. Bard is, of course, another option.
Rek'Sai also standing.
Yes.
Available for Chelby to take if he would like. We know he is a good Rek'Sai player. Gets rid of that champion from Juve's. It's something they should be looking towards as a first pick.
Juve's had almost 100% kill participation on that Rek'Sai at the end of that game as well. That was a lot of kills.
He did well. Juve's, again, like he jungled well.
Yeah.
Was able to control the map as best he could, but Sin just struggled all around in the early game. They got it together late game, and he was always a part of that.
Oh my god. Okay, Paradise going to go straight for the Jax.
Okay.
No fear.
I guess by going for this early Jax, he's making the assumption that it's going to be a Shen.
Yeah.
We've seen it succeed into Shen. Of course, it can defuse a fair bit of auto attack damage if timed well, but longer cooldowns means that Squiggle might have a bad time.
It also means that Sin now get to pick the Rek'Sai as well as something else that they would like. It's not exactly like Jax fell all the way through the draft last time around.
Yeah, I don't think they were expecting Sin to lock that one down for them.
No.
Especially not in a first rotation. Like, I'd expect from Sin here as a response to probably even go for the Rek'Sai with maybe an Ezreal or Sivir, something like that, that can be hidden. Something maybe even like a Braum if they wanted, but I'd say one of the bottom lane, or they can continue that strategy that we expected.
Yeah, take away the Shen here for Squiggle. So Rek'Sai going to be taken there from Juve. So no surprises coming in from Sin for their first round, but AV definitely changing things with that particular decision.
Yeah. I mean, again, the reason I didn't expect the Shen in this rotation is because Jax is already there.
Yeah.
But they don't actually need to pick the Shen, but it shows that Sin definitely wanted that champion regardless, and they were going to lock it in. And maybe this is a really cerebral move from Avant, saying, we recognize that you're going to pick Shen. We're actually just going to pick Jax into it. And I believe AV in the past have actually won this exact matchup and game scenario where they've picked themselves a Jax into a Shen. So, I mean, for what it's worth, it felt forced as a first pick. They do concede the Rek'Sai, but they get a matchup they were potentially looking for.
Well, of course, Paradise did play Jax twice. He went 8-1-3 in the first game against Abyss, and then 13-2-3 against the Hellions on the same champion. So the guy does definitely do some work. If he was against Shens, then my goodness, that is terrifying. But you can see Jake back to the Bard, and Chelby going to pick up his Elise. So a lot more focus on pick here for AV, and no Lanterns to get any Sin members out of trouble, as well as no Hawkshots to try and spot out them setting up any gank brushes. And I actually like the fact that they've played towards these bans that they have thrown out here on the side of Avant.
And this is something we expected from AV with their first game drafting, to be perfectly honest. Rek'Sai was being a first pick. They could respond with the Elise. Instead, they went for the Gragas, which was matching Sin's strengths.
Yep.
This time around, AV are playing to their own strengths and letting Sin do theirs and just meeting them in the middle.
Well, now Triple has to lock away his mid lane at Rhymeister. Can head towards something like a Twisted Fate if he wants to for the last rotation. Could be very scary here for AV, unless Triple decides to go for it himself, and then they'll have even more pick potential around the map, as well as vision control.
Yeah. I actually think the Triple should take the TF away from Sin, potentially. It's a Shen, Twisted Fate composition,
exactly.
They have done.
And a Rek'Sai as well, so much maneuverability.
Yeah, and speaking of not having a Lantern or an Ash Hawkshot, they still have Juve's with the Tremor Sense.
Yeah.
They can still spot people out if they look around major objectives. So, again, Sin, they've set themselves up well enough. Sivir Spell Shield, Braum disengage, Shen to save people. They can round their team composition out with anything they'd like, whether it's they go for 1-3-1 dependent on what AV finish their comp with, or they can match it, something like a Twisted Fate, which is this hybrid between 1-3-1 and team fighting, or they can just go all in with Control Mage and Orianna on them.
Yeah, they could certainly Orianna if they want to. Of course, something like the Cassiopeia here for Rhymeister, you could just take it to Triple, do the same thing. Throw that gauntlet, as it were, as Victor is picked up with the Ezreal here for AV. And Kassadin just one more time here for Rhymeister. If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
It's funny, this time around, I'd say he's got a better matchup.
Yeah.
I mean, Kassadin into Victor, it's a 50% win rate that goes both directions internationally. Mm-hmm. I believe the LCK has more success as the Victor, the LPL has more success as the Kassadin, so
yep.
Take from that what you will. I'd say that Rhymeister's much more an LPL inclined player with the
style. I would say so, yes.
The Sin, they've set themselves up nicely. This is basically what they did against Legacy. Win with a team composition, have them ban away that one, and then just pick your strong other composition.
Yeah, and the thing that we've actually spoken about, Sin, as far as their weaknesses, I guess, is when they don't play towards what they're good at. And right now, once again, they've got all of their damage focus on Rhymeister and Raps. Last time it worked out just fine. This time, looking to potentially do the same thing again as Squiggle. Once again, focusing on utility. Juves, once again, vision control, map control on the rec side. This is something that he's incredibly comfortable with. And Rogue is probably the one that we're looking for. Doesn't have necessarily as much playmaking potential now on the Braum as opposed to the Thresh.
That's right. He needs to actually enable his team. Hit the Q, maybe someone else on the team can get the stun. But you're absolutely right, Avian. Sin have played their own styles this time.
Well, we'll see who's going to be able to win this one as we want to hear from you. Use the hashtag AVWin. Get behind Avant. See whether they can make their way back into this series. Or use that hashtag SinWin if you think that Sin will be able to finish this one off 2-0. Of course, T-Gun on the desk. Probably going to be pretty excited about a potential Sin victory here as it's one step closer for Abyss to get into our playoffs.
Yeah, absolutely right. AV 1-0 down, trying to find consistency not only as a roster that they have now established, but as a team of five strong solo queue inclined players now coming together and branching away from the norm.
And do we think that AV's comp now sort of represents Avant a little bit better than the last one did? Just with having Paradise on that hard carry in the Jax, Chelby, a lot of pick potential on the Elisa champion that he's had a lot of success on in the past?
Yeah, of course. It feels much more AV. The Gnar to me is similar to the Trundle, but it has multi-purpose opposed to a Trundle's one defined purpose, which is the split push and ult a tank so that you are one and that they're not one, and kill that person immediately. Trundle excels at this, whereas Gnar was a bit of both. Paradise, he's thrown that out the window and said, now I'm just going to carry.
Yep.
But that seems to be when AV actually win.
Damn right. And if his current KDA on Jax is anything to go on, he's probably going to look pretty damn good doing it. Because I believe the scoreline goes something like 19-4 with not too many assists, because this guy just likes to kill people.
Well, I mean, one time he was struggling, they fumbled a lane swap AV, and then he just rocks up to a fight and gets a quadra kill at about 8 minutes. So.
Yeah, Sin, remember that flanking teleport looking pretty good.
Yeah, these things definitely happen. Sin need to show the utmost respect to that Jax. Whether it's standard lanes or lane swapping, it doesn't matter. This is really cute from AV.
Yeah, Counter-Strike going to be used to keep AV very healthy as they take down this red buff as well. See the bottom lane start here for AV as they take down their Krog camp. And the lane swap is going to ensue.
They're about to find each other here.
Tremorsense is going to spot them out as well, as now Juice could come over the top, see whether he can get a smite as the Counter-Strike is going to come in. Squiggle going to get stunned up as he flashes out of the way. Rhymeister also taking some damage there from Chelby, who also flashes. Rogue comes in. Four members of Sin now to defend their Raptor camp. They get two flashes out of it.
Yeah, two flashes. Just looking for an opportunity to actually kill AV, who we already said it was greedy going for the red buff. Well, the Raptors is all in.
Yeah.
Aggressive move from them. I guess they expected Sin to not be that forward themselves. But the second the Bard goes missing, Sin should be reacting to that fact. They're the ones putting the lane swap into effect. They took the Cheeky Wolf and then tried to move over. They don't get a red buff for what it's worth. AV don't die. The Rhymeister going over at level 1 really does shut the door on AV's chances. He had nothing to offer to that besides an able body and still is able to push them out.
Well, you can see Chelby going for a 4-buff start potentially here as Juves is going to move into the enemy blue side jungle. However, this Elise is going to have 2 red buffs and a blue in his back pocket, 2 of those buffs being from the enemy side of the map.
Yeah, constantly forward, always invading. At least this time it is working towards his team's strong side of the map.
Yep.
You look past this and you would imagine he'll get the red buff before recalling and then going to the top side to complement the second part of any basic lane swap maneuvers. Still, pathing decently well, Chelby, albeit aggressive and potentially could get in trouble for it.
One thing I do like as well is AV's team comp in a lane swap scenario, just with Jax having the passive, lots of lane swap damage. They are going to be able to take down that turret first, as you can see. Sin not too far behind, as Squiggle will want to kill as many of these minions as possible. We'll get that wave into a decent position.
Yeah, does his best there. And again, top lane is now trying to ooze out every little aspect of farm that they can acquire before somebody comes up and ruins the party. Both teams have even set up that deep vision to allow them, so this does look like a standard lane swap breaking out.
Oh, really nice spot from Barney there as Juice takes a meep slap afterwards as well.
Gets hit by the Lord of Thunder.
Mm-hmm. Pretty good Keystone Mastery for a Brad. Yeah, it is. Now Triple just going to wait. Rhymaster going to teleport his way back in. Of course, this time, AV also with the double teleport. We'll see whether that's going to nullify some of what Sin were able to bring in the late game last time around, especially with their maneuverability. So Rhymaster now with the back under his belt, feeling a little bit more confident. Okay. Dark Seal and the Ruby Crystal actually going to help his combat power quite a lot with that Corrupting Potion.
Yeah, it definitely is. I think having the Dark Seal pickup, a bit of added sustain, one of the downsides of a Victor sometimes is that you have to wait until you have 1,000 gold before you go back to base, unless you're going all in on the Negatron Cloak route because of lane pressure. But there you go. Manages to get it successfully. Not that he shouldn't have been successful against the Kassadin.
It's true. Not a lot of early lane pressure.
Yeah.
Especially when it's Triple as well. I mean, this guy we saw, he was no slouch in the last game, especially early on. He's going to get the double tap on that Death Ray as well as Rhymaster using his health bar a bit as a resource to try and get these minions. Sin, going to take down this outer turret towards the bottom side. Is Paradise going to come in and get some whacks onto this turret?
Yeah, so the second part of this is continuing. However, Sin have been completely out-rotated through the jungle roll. See a big CS advantage actually grown for Chelby.
Yeah.
And Juves is walking around aimlessly in the enemy jungle with nothing to take.
Well, you can see Sin now as well. Might need to respond to AV, who've got a big minion wave continuing to push through here on the top side of the map. Cloudrake is the first dragon, so AV don't really care about whether that one falls. Triple, you can see, just edging around the top side of this mid lane, making sure that he's on the strong side. And there are on the way pings from Sin, looking to try and save this inner turret on the top side and see whether they can.
Yeah, really good movement from AV once again. Over-pushing, utilizing the advantage that they had. Juves needs to show some respect.
Whoa.
And now they want to defend this.
Big summoner spell comes out as Juice does manage to get a knock up onto Chelby, who turns it around. Juice having to flash as the ignite sticking down. No, it's just a red buff. Sin take a fair bit of damage as they're looking to clean this one up. But look at that. That inner turret is not going to regen, and that's a lot of damage from AV.
So first and foremost, I said that Juves needed to be careful. Well, he did. But he also manages to dodge the Bard Q and the Elise Cocoon at the start of that fight. Otherwise, he was dead.
Yeah.
So he gets out by the skin of his teeth. And that's not a lot to keep him alive. That turret is still very low, and as you mentioned, it doesn't regenerate. AV, they make the first good proactive move, breaking from the norm.
Well, now Triple looking to try and get some damage down this outer turret. Gets one auto attack, and then Rhymeister is left to clean up these minions underneath the turret. You can see minion lead for Triple is relatively pronounced here at 64, as one of them is a ward, at least. Mm-hmm. Chelby continuing his onslaught of the jungle, now actually almost ahead by 50%.
Yeah, he's doing really well here, Chelby. Of course, Rhymeister's working towards his big items, so Rogue's actually just hanging out, trying to slow any mid lane pushes down. And now that both turrets have been broken on both sides of the map, Rogue can afford to do this. Oddly enough, it works out for them.
Of course, last time around, Sin didn't exactly have the best early game. This point, still looking better than they were last game, and Rhymeister just wants to scale. We can see what this guy can do with the Kassadin in the later stages. There's the Cocoon landing onto Juves, though. This is the pick potential of this comp. Really nice Cosmic Binding comes in, and Juves actually having to get out of his own jungle.
Completely pushed out once again. Pressure there from AV. And whilst it's pressure, I don't think it's actually direct kill threat. They are still playing the numbers game, though, and it's favoring AV because it's poking out Sin, and Rhymeister is very deep.
He most certainly is. The exhaust is already there, as well as Chelby's looking for the Cocoon. Cocoon gets it. There's the Chaos Storm. True Shot Barrage is going to help out. Everyone gets assists for this one, apart from Paradise, but Triple picks up the kill, and that is a big deal for Avant.
That is big for Avant, but it's also inexcusable from Rhymeister. I have nothing nice to say about that movement from him. He just watched Juves get half health, get pushed out of his own jungle, and then cleared a ward in the river against the Bard. Of course they're going to collapse on you.
Well, hopefully he doesn't make a mistake like that again, as the teleport almost off cooldown, but not going to be there enough to try and challenge this Cloudrake, which they're probably not too worried about as well. AV just looking to try and get to the next one here this game. Next dragon is going to be a mountain, probably one that they'd prefer at this point.
Yeah, Cloudrake.
Yeah.
So impactful.
Damn right.
It's like if they were an enchantment, they'd be called the boots of move ever so slightly faster than previously, but not enough that it's impactful to the game's result.
And only out of combat.
Yeah. Yeah. Boots of mobility occasionally.
Boots of peaceful alacrity. As triple. They're getting closed in on here. Nice gravity field comes down as Rogue is going to take the double tap from the Death Ray. Juice throws out a Prey Seeker before exiting. And triple expertly clears out the minions.
Yeah, doing well in this middle lane, especially in the 1v1, let alone having the pressure of the rest of Sin here. Rogue's basically a mid laner. And of course, Rhymeister having teleport, it does feel like we're at that point in the game where for some reason he's now in a side lane, except that he's against the Jax. And I normally wouldn't look at that and say that's a great idea. But Paradice not level 6. Rhymeister actually has a big farm advantage when you compare top laners at any stage of the game where there's been a lane swap. It's actually not too bad for the Kassadin.
Well, now Juice looking to try and get out of here as the teleport's actually coming in. You can see Triple's going to make his way through, wants to get his blue buff, and is going to do so successfully. Rhymeister teleports immediately towards the bottom side of the map as every side lane is belong to him.
Yeah. Poor Squiggle.
Yeah.
Thankfully, the wave that was in the top lane was cleared out by Rhymeister, so it bounces back now. He's not just running around with no idea where to go, but he's on a Shen this time and does want to be finding some side lane farm. You can't just completely relegate him to grouping. Actually, it makes no sense as a Shen.
Rogue going to take a little bit of damage here from Shelby, but otherwise isn't too worried. And Triple's going to come in and make sure that he is. Chaos Storm comes down, has to flash the wall. Actually does. So not the stand behind me used as On the Hunt comes out of wraps just to make sure that he gets out.
AV don't find the pick, but they get a lot of pressure still down. They can't work towards a Drake, unfortunately, as that's already been taken by them. And this next movement on Summoner's Rift was explicitly to catch Rogue out of position when he was far too forward inside the enemy jungle. Once again, had no reason to really be there besides securing vision for a mid lane push, potentially. Backfires.
Well, you can see Paradice now with the wave one more time, very close to his turret. And the Jax is getting some much-needed free time with a whole host of minions. You can see Triple as well. I mean, he didn't move out of the mid lane.
Yeah.
He's continuing to just take as many creeps as possible. Now, approximately ahead of the clock.
But this is my big concern with Sin, and it just continues to happen. This team composition is designed to have Squiggle split pushing. You want a control mage in the middle lane, perhaps, for Rhymeister. Maybe the Twisted Fate, I think, still would have been a better
choice.
Yeah,
I think so too.
But as an end result of this, they've got Rhymeister awkwardly rotating around the map, picking up farm everywhere, which puts Squiggle behind in experience and CS as well. They then have the Sivir come mid. He keeps even with Chenny Boy, but Chenny's still the recipient of a lot of farm, whereas AV are completely stock standard. Triple just clears waves, just plays that Victor, just farms mid lane up and has a great time on Summoner's Rift.
And I feel like a great time is being had by Paradice as well. I mean,
exactly.
No pressure on him at all. Just chilling out. I'm a Jax. Waiting for the items. And getting there as well. As Magical Journey gets Jakey in. Chenny Boy going to follow up as now they start the siege here. But no more minions. Chenny just going to take a celebratory turret shot. And it's 2,000 gold the lead here for Avant. Even on turrets, it's just the first blood and some extra farm here, mostly for the Jax and the Elise. It's one of the first times that I've seen Elise with such a commanding CS lead.
Yeah, he's just been controlling jungle through invades and a lot of aggressive pandering. As once again, they crash this down. They break the freeze that could have been there from the Shen. They deny him farm.
Wow, look at that burst damage as well as Triple comes down. The Chaos Storm's there getting damage onto both Rogue and Juice underneath this turret. Paradice trying to tank things up. As you can see, he gets on top. The exhaust is there. But AV gets so much pressure. I'm not entirely sure who was tanking that turret, but they did a pretty good job because no one died and they take themselves the inner.
Such a clean-cut game so far from AV.
Yeah.
Feels like every move that Sin makes or every move that they are forced to make by AV is always favoring our blue team right now from minute one.
Oh, I want to see what they can do here. The blue buff is going to respawn. AV will be able to lock that one down. Rhymeister comes in. They're all sitting in the brush. There's the Cosmic Binding as Squiggle's trying to make his way through. Everyone piling on top of Rhymeister, who gets a nice Force Pulse off. And Shelby steals away the blue buff. Rhymeister's going to give up a bunch of his health bar, and they use a lot of their buttons here as Juves. Not quite in there on time.
Chenny
they get
flashed.
The flash out of Chenny. Exactly.
Yeah, so he gets out alive. They get the blue buff. They put damage on a Rhymeister. Once again, Sin are trying to scale. They want to get this Kassadin into a point where he's super relevant and can take people out. However, I don't see him being able to 1v1 a Jax. He has to be involved in teamfights or the side lane that is completely unthreatened, which means Squiggle is the one supposed to deal with the Jax. That's also impossible.
Yeah, good luck. Shelby just throws out some harassment here onto Rogue one more time. Still doesn't have his flash, but will be up very, very soon. The outer turret not going to have too much pressure on it here from Sin, as everyone was moving back on the side of a barn. Triple will have his teleport soon. Squiggle, of course, has his, but no ultimate. It's Paradise just killing as much as he possibly can. Now 101 CS to 36. Things looking good for Jax. Continues. Feels like a sitcom.
Good things with Jax.
Feels
everybody
good
loves
to be Jax.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, it does. It feels great to be Jax right now.
I'm going to have a look at the champ.
He's got like 300 gold, probably going to be his Trinity Force compared to nothing from Squiggle. Honestly, that's the story of this game.
He's got a shirt and some calcifer. He's looking good. He doesn't have a Trinity Force, though. Damn right he doesn't. You're right, Paradise picks his up. Rhymeister gets some decent harassment onto Triple there. We'll have to respect the next Rift Walk.
Again, it's like a 50-50 matchup in this middle lane, yet Rhymeister decides to go to a side lane far too early. Doesn't give the matchup a chance.
And Sin caught sleeping here just a little bit as AV will be able to grab themselves the dragon as well as this pink ward. Chenny Boy wants to clear out some tunnels, and they are going to do that right under Juve's nose. And AV with still a lot of defensive and offensive vision around this map. Know where people are rotating from Sin and can answer accordingly.
I think they actually want to dive triple here, but with a bard nearby, that is unlikely to be successful.
And they'll never have a creep wave, because it's a Victor.
They're now looking to honestly collapse on Rhymeister as well. Good luck.
Yeah, and Paradise, he's going to get the Counter-Strike off here as well. Rhymeister's taking so much damage. Grandmeister's Might comes out from Paradise. Isn't going to be able to utilize it. As Sin, once again, throughout an ultimate, and Paradise says, this is my blue buff. I worked hard for it.
This is what I don't get, is Juve's is not the one starting the blue buff. It's Rhymeister. He's basically the jungler, the mid laner, and the top laner for this team right now.
Here could be the turnaround as Jakey getting tumbled on. Rhymeister, of course, teleporting in. True Shot Barrage flies through, and Sin don't get anything for the summon as well.
Teleport for flash. No kills to be seen, no gold to be had, and that's what they desperately need. There's no snowball even capable from this Sin side, and AV just press that lead further.
Now Paradise going to come down, smack on this big purple Herald. They are going to be able to get it relatively quickly here. Paradise going to have even more split pushing power here on the Jax. Sin trying to go for some sort of dive onto triple as Rhymeister picks up Tarot Aggro, and the minion wave's dealt with. Cosmic Binding, sorry, not going to find the mark. Shelby comes around threatening the cocoon, but Sin get out.
Yeah, and the four-man threat that AV have actually becoming five now. Starting to become an issue for Sin.
This turret is basically dead as the Mystic Shot threads through. There's another teleport to come in as Squiggle trying to make his presence known. Shelby under, but Rhymice is going to fall down. Chenny Boy picks up the kill as Gravity Field's doing decent work. Paradise going to get stunned up there as Squiggle comes over. You can see Juve's very, very low. Has to tunnel his way out as Squiggle's going to die. AV now looking for the Rek'Sai. Paradise just leaps his way forward. And Triple picks it up with a really nice flash death ray. And AV now going to continue pressure towards the bottom inhibitor turret. And they've got a huge minion wave.
Yeah, here's a minion wave I prepared earlier. We're now on a cooking show as well.
Yeah,
as
this
the
is Jamie Oliver right now.
AV, they are just dismantling Sin at a fundamental level. They get turret after turret, kill after kill, and it all starts through a lane swap that Sin wanted. Maybe not anymore.
Yeah, precisely. And you can see Paradise is so far ahead in the farm, now only has one assist, but it just flat out doesn't matter because who answers this guy? We saw him winning the 1v1 versus Rhymeister. If he gets any more items, it's almost going to be lights out for any sort of, I guess, strategic play that Sin are going to try and put into place.
And again, it feels like they just spent too much effort trying to empower a Kassadin whose base scaling takes a long time to achieve super amounts of importance, right? So the Shen doesn't get to the point where he needs to be. In fact, he gets behind that point because AV empower the Jax to farm. Sin don't give anything to the Shen. You look at the middle lane. They had a Sivir farming there, which means Rhymeister is rotating around the map. And once again, it's the pick of the Kassadin to me that actually separates what Sin want to do to how they can actually do it.
Yeah. And I mean, I'm going to say something in defense of Squiggle as well, because I mean, yes, this guy doesn't necessarily carry. He often plays utility, but in this team, I don't know what else he could do. To be perfectly honest, just with how Sin delegate their farm and resources so heavily to Rhymeister and of course Raps as well, who often gets a lot out of it.
Yeah, I just sometimes it's frustrating, but when you see it work, you can appreciate what it's there for.
Yeah,
like Sin, they have one really good strength, and they can play to that strength and win games through it. But whenever they lose games, it's because that strength is actually starting to become a weakness in some way. Whether it's too much emphasis on Rhymeister, so they don't find the balance right. Whether it's that they put their top laner behind and AV have a big carry threat now in that Jax that they first picked, by the way.
Yeah.
Into the Shen that's used as a counter.
It's definitely working out so far as Chenny Boy and Jake now setting up here towards the top side of the map. Sin lying in wait, doing what they can to try and catch this one out as Chenny Boy doesn't necessarily find anyone, but then eventually hits the Mystic Shot and Sin's game is up. Is in a turret that they got a lot of damage done in the early game is now going to fall at exactly 20 minutes, and that's 6 turrets to 2 in favor of AV, who didn't get the inhibitor but got the inhibitor turret from that previous push.
Now Rhymeister may get this. We'll see if he pays the iron price for it, because honestly he is a bit out of position. AV can threaten this though as the big gem, the prize jewel that they actually want to acquire.
That has a red buff as well. This is so scary.
I just don't think there's anything Sin can do. They just need to hold on, strap in, and hope they get to a late game.
Well, it's 6,000 gold, the lead for AV. It was approximately that at the height of AV's lead in game number one. So theoretically, if things go the same, Sin can turn this one around. But it does feel like a very different game, especially comp-wise, for AV. Looks like they have answered what some of their problems were moving into game number one as far as finishing things off. This all starts on the top side of the map.
Yeah. And it's snowballed out of control on that top side. Right now, Sin making a play.
Yeah, Paradise looking for the counter-strike. Gets a lot of damage onto Rhymeister there as Grandmaster's Might is in. Paradise looking to step on a Tempered Fate. Wait for his team to come round, and Sin can't pick up the top laner.
Gives a high five to his team and says, thanks, bro.
Yeah.
Kept him alive. Sin walk away. Don't get the kill. Now AV pressure the middle lane in response, knowing that there's two people missing.
Yeah, Gravity Field goes down. There's the Chaos Storm as well from Triple as Rogue's taking a lot of damage. Can't move out of that ultimate as the Rylai's is keeping him there. Will have to move out very, very low as now Juve's looking to the engage. Nice Magical Journey gets AV all together and out of the way as the teleport's coming in. Paradise looking to make his
Rogue.
Presence known as Rogue. Didn't mean to press that one as Paradise leaps on top. Can't quite find the kill as Rogue's able to flash away. Rhymeister now just clearing out the mid lane.
And Rogue did not want to follow that one. He definitely regretted it. AV getting a second Mountain Drake. Sin actually just want the turrets.
Yeah, Rhymeister looking to put some pressure on, but knows that he's not going to be able to steal too much away from an Elise with Smite. Sin just going to be backing away. Don't get anything as AV move around the map, picking up exactly what they want. Shelby may lose his life. Is the Magical Journey, will it still be there? Oh my god, that timing was very close. Of course, Rhymeister does have Riftwalk, so Chelby has to be very careful. His Volatile Spiderling, not going to spot him out.
He wants this so badly. He's a stalker right now.
Just knows exactly where Chelby's going to be as well as he throws down the cocoon. Rhymeister not going to be able to find the kill. Don't get baited. Oh god, you are a brave man, Chelby.
Chelby knows what he wants. Chelby gets what he wants. Right now, Rhymeister now actually pushes to near that mid lane. Again, Triple. I think he's strong enough to contend with this.
Yeah, he's got the health built up from that Rylai's as well, so feeling pretty good.
As again, AV in complete control of Summoner's Rift, that the Kassadin is spending all of his time sitting in a bush, and he's not winning the game.
No,
that means he could be farming side lanes. Shen can't even really farm side lanes because he's being harassed endlessly. The Ezreal is hard to kill. The Bard can save everybody's life. They've got Poke, they've got Siege, they've got team fighting,
and they've got Split Push. As you can see on the bottom side of the map, as the Leap Strike had to be used there from Paradise to get him out of the way, but it got themselves the inner turret here in the mid lane. 7 turrets now to 3 as AV continue to push their lead forward. 7,000 gold approximately the lead. Now AV going to move over to this open inhibitor. Possible team fight to break out here. We'll see whether AV are once again going to struggle in this phase of the game, whether they're going to have it together. The cocoons are going to have to land, and the AoE is going to have to be strong here from Triple. as Jenny Boy gets chunked by Rhymeister. Nice stun going to come down from Jake, but it's a really nice unbreakable to stop that death ray, and Rhymeister getting a lot of damage over the top. There's the Glacial Fissure as Paradise gets exhausted. Tempered Fate onto so many members of Sin, though, as Jubes is taking a lot of damage.
Wiggle
gets massive work done, but Rhymeister always has to be respected. Triple kill immediately, as now he's still looking for more, but he's ran out of mana entirely. And Shelby, over the back, is able to stop the rest of this team from coming through. Raps, oh my god! That was a big ricochet.
And
now Shelby looking for more. Yeah, exactly right. Squiggle doesn't have a lot of damage, but Triple's going to be locked down. Gets the empowered auto attacks and locks up the mid laner. That is four dead for Avant. And Sin only lose Jubes.
Yeah, I don't think they can immediately go to this. Is a big risk if they actually look at the Baron. There is so much vision there from the side of AV. They have their jungler standing. And I mean, Jubes can use his Farm Alarm and get in, but they shouldn't actually do it. Instead, I think they just wanted to bait. Shelby, that's a big teamfight win.
Yeah.
For Sin.
And one more time, this is Sin turning up when it comes to teamfights.
I think the real response is that they shouldn't be teamfighting AV, but a Kassadin just ramming his head at you until you turn it around, even with a fantastic Tempered Fate and a Jax in your team, they didn't even get the teamfight win. That's one thing that you expect to see from AV, but once more, they hold strong. The Shen ults the Kassadin. All of those eggs in one basket still works for Sin. Their identity is so steadfast in its presence.
It is. Oh, that was beautiful. Well played, well played. Now Triple just going to easily clear out this wave. So nothing really gained as far as objectives are concerned here for Sin, which is why they're still down by about 5,000 gold. However, 2-2-1 for the Kassadin as Rhymeister switching up the build a little bit, going to grab himself a Lich Bane. A little bit more focus on cooldown reduction now, as he will have 30% at this point.
Yeah, it means he's going to be doing a lot more dueling potential, perhaps, for Paradise.
With the Zhonya's, that's 40%. That is huge for the Kassadin.
Yeah. Again, one of the benefits of the new mage itemization as well, being that fact. A lot of champions, such as Twisted Fate and Kassadin, can go defensive items, get cooldown reduction, and still have a strong kit, because their items didn't really change in build path, just in what they provide.
Well, you can see Triple wants to finish himself. What looks like a Void Staff is his third item. It's going to be very important to pick that one up, as there is a couple of Spectre's Cows and Abyssal Scepter in there already, and Aegis of the Legion has been completed by Rogue. And they're going to be relying on Triple for a lot of their damage, especially in an AoE for AV.
I guess a major cause for concern as well is the amount of magic damage that's going to be coming out of the two poke-heavy champions. Chenny's the big important point, and he's also been called, even by Tegan, one of the weaker links of this team, something that AV usually put on a facilitative role. Ezreal's purpose in that case is then to slow people down, but he needs to be doing damage.
He does have the items for it at this stage. 2-1-3, he hasn't had a bad game, but he's once again falling behind a heck of a lot on farm.
That's exactly what the problem was in game number one as well.
Yeah, true.
If Sin can hold their base for another 5 to 10 minutes, even start to push their way out and keep things towards an even pace, Raps is getting further ahead of Chenny because they're empowering Paradise, and that's where we actually find a shift in where strength lies.
Yeah.
At the moment, Squiggle's job is not to be able to 1v1, it's to be able to wave clear. They can actually send, and what they are doing right now, Sin, is putting Rhymeister down there with him. They both have teleport anyway. If it takes two people to stop Paradise from pushing, then so be it.
Yeah.
They just teleport in and fight.
Well, one thing that it is going to be bad for, I guess, is Rhymeister catching back up. However, he's only down by about 3 CS in comparison to Triple, who's just been doing what he wants here around the map. You can see AV complete control at this point of the top side of the map. This Baron well and truly in their sphere of influence. But Jubes, once again on the Rek'Sai, knows exactly where everyone on AV is. The Cocoon is going to land. He actually takes a fair bit of damage right now. Chenny landing the Mystic Shots. Jubes has to be very careful as Rhymeister gets over the top. Chenny Boy is immediately able to get out of there, but Rogue picks up the kill in the end. Jakey gets himself out, but he's going to get stunned and destroyed. And Sin set that one up beautifully. Oh my god, Raps is going to get paradised as the Leap Strike comes in. They do manage to lock him down. That is a lot of the consistent damage now missing on the side of Sin, and Paradise may have bought them some time. However, it's only Shelby and Triple alive.
Yeah, I think Paradise might have actually saved them from losing too many turrets, given that the four remaining members are tanks or melee champions. I question if Sin can go past this without a dive, and onto Triple, that's risky. They will get one for it. They also get another big team fight where, Drew's was super low. I think he was too busy looking towards finding the way into that fight. But it works out. He's got magic resistance, people poking him and magic damage. He didn't even have to use his flash in the end. In fact, he gained health by the end of that fight.
Well, you can see AV now actually moving straight to the Baron Pit. The Mountain Drake is available.
They're expecting Sin to be doing the Mountain Drake. That assumption makes sense, but they immediately kick off the Baron. Sin are going to be close. Rek'Sai is now checking.
Yeah, well, they're trying to burn this one down extraordinarily quickly. You can see Pink Ward jumps into the pit as Juves is going to have to go for the steal. We'll see whether Chelby can lock that one down. Knight's knock
Juves!
Up. And he steals it away. Juves is going to die for it, but that's exactly what Sin wanted.
And the saving grace for Sin right now is Juves with
Juves
the
clutch is having the series
smite.
Of his life right now.
That's really clutch from him, actually. And any snowball that AV could have completely turned around from a one team fight from Sin is now negated. The 4v5 is only 20 seconds long. And they only get themselves the dragon. It's a consolation Drake.
Well, it certainly is. It is going to be their third, so they'll have a heck of a lot of turret damage. However, doesn't really matter. Sin now with the Baron buff, and you can see already Rhymeister utilizing it to push out this top side of the map. AV don't exactly have minion waves in any good position to try and respond.
So one good thing as well about the Baron is Rhymeister's got empowered recalls. We're past 20 minutes, so he has the home guard's buff. And whilst he doesn't have teleport, he can get to a fight near his inhibitor extremely quickly. And because he's got the Lich Bane build, he can still threaten side lane. So maybe he doesn't have a teleport. It's not really a problem for him.
Well, he definitely will be able to take this inner turret. Does so incredibly quickly. Now AV pressuring onto this open inhibitor. Paradise getting some auto attack damage onto it and is going to utilize the Counter-Strike in order to make sure that he's not pushed away. So inhibitor falls and now AV looking to try and get out. There's on the hunt
juice.
As everyone is going to take this one. Stand United comes down on top of Juice. True Shot Barrage is good as Tempered Fate is not going to find any targets and Squiggle has got right in amongst it. Chelby takes another magical journey as you can see Sinner following relentlessly Chaos Storm to try and deter them. Fantastic use, of course, of the Rylai's Crystal Scepter slows Sin down, and AV get an inhibitor for free.
And the big mistake there was we spoke to what Rhymeister can do with the Baron empowered recall, get back to base, but he doesn't do it early enough. He actually expected them to not hard push in that aggressively. And playing towards AV's tendencies backfires for the mid laner of Sin. They look for a fight, but it was 2 seconds too late because once again the Kassadin arrives 2 seconds too late. They did chase pretty far.
Yeah.
Sin still look like they want to find a fight. But with that bottom lane inhibitor now missing, AV only have two lanes they need to focus.
Well, that has been exactly what Sin's been able to do this game, is team fight. I don't think they've lost one when all of their members are there and they've been the ones able to instigate. As once again, Triple now having to flash out of the way. Chenny Boy gets obliterated as Chelby's going to follow suit. Massive kills for both carries from Sin. Onto the jungler and, of course, the AD carry. They do have triple for wave clear, but is it going to be enough now? As you can see, Juice just tanking up this turret. Seems like the lack of minions doesn't matter here for Sin, as Juice is so tanky. They are going to be able to take this one down. Juice gets out of the way. They lock up the inhibitor turret. It's now Jake caught out of position by Rhymeister. Decent use of the gravity field, but doesn't get the stun. As Ryze able to get out, utilizes the Riftwalk, and they take themselves the inhibitor of their own.
God,
as Triple is going to get melted. And Paradise as well, now in trouble, has to leap out of
now
the way. Tempered Fate used, and you can see now Sin just going to push forward. Could this now be the end of the game? As Chelby's up in a second, Jenny Boy as well. Paradise looking to try and find his way in as Nexus turrets are falling quickly. Squiggle is going to be the first one to die. Raps is going to get destroyed by Paradise. Rogue is going to follow as now AV get a triple kill for Chelby, of all people.
Yeah, Chelby gets three kills. They actually hold off. They were looking to you. Oh my god,
oh,
here we go.
This is the 1v1 we've been waiting for, but there are super creeps here, Paradise. You have to be careful, buddy. There's now Rhymeister looking for him. There's the Leaf Strike. They switch positions as he dodges a bit of the damage. Paradise wants it. He's got the lifesteal. And the Counter-Strike is there.
Rhymeister out of mana, so could not continue that. Of course, too many ultimates causes someone to run out of their mana pool as Kassadin. AV, though, they're looking extremely strong. That is Triple's teleport, so...
Oh my god, they are throwing teleports everywhere on the side of Avanis. Chelby and Jake are going to turn up. Chenny Boy over the wall. They take themselves the inhibitor turret as Rhymeister looking for Paradise one more time. Went back, got himself some health. Doesn't find the Force Pulse as the inhibitor falls down. Having the Kassadin out of this fight is such a huge deal. And Paradise didn't even die.
Yeah, so I think Sin's strategy there initially was to make sure Paradise dies and then utilize Squiggle and Rhymeister to end the game. What he's doing right now is teleporting on a big flank. Rhymeister at it again.
This is both of these teams just trying to make plays around this map. Chaosstorm comes in, triple is going to die as Squiggle turns up with the Stand United.
Oh no, this is actually a big window. Sin 4v5.
Look at this base though, that's two inhibitors dead.
So they're racing against the bottom lane and top lane all the same. If they can win this game by brute forcing mid with super minions, it's something that AV may not be able to defend. They've got a Shen who can defend with his teleport up, not the ulti.
Yeah.
It's a little bit important that it's going to be missing. AV need to win this fight. If they don't win and push them out, they lose the game.
Well, this Nexus turret is on no health as a teleport is going to come in from Squiggle. On the Hunt goes down as well as Tempered Fate. Blocks up Rhymeister and Rogue. Juves is going to get taken down first, but he's not exactly the priority target. Raps still alive as Paradise does eventually get it. And he's creating a lot of pressure here for Avant. Rhymeister turns it around and it is Squiggle picking up a kill. Zonyas comes out from Rhymeister waiting for the rest of Sin to come in. Open Nexus now, but you can see the base of Sin is in a shambles and Raps had a lot of their damage. Chelby now trying to stop some backs. 40 seconds on Paradise, but Triple's still here. He's turned back up. Chelby still wants this one as he's looking for the cocoon. Juves, very, very low. Cosmic Binding doesn't find Rogue, but they have slowed him down. And that is going to be the Braum falling. 1 minute on Baron, 40 seconds on Elder Drake, but AV have their hearts set on taking down this Sin Nexus. Makes sense. Yeah. That wins you the game.
And we're seesawing right now. Rhymeister needs to go back, get some mana. If he doesn't, then the game's just completely over. Sin, they had a power play. They looked towards it, and it's still going to be a 5v5 because they can't end the game here, AV. And whilst they look for the inhibitor, the fact that Raps is up pushes them off. This is actually a seesaw.
Yep. And AV do not want it to continue as they all move out of the base. Both Nexus turrets, I believe, are now dead. Here for Sin, as well as AV. This game will come down to one fight, and that will finish it very abruptly.
Well, we say that, but the difference is, Sin are losing fights inside AV's base.
Rhymeister walks straight into a cocoon. He'll get exploded. The shutdown comes in, as now Sin have to move away from this Elder Drake. AV, that is a big old pick.
And that's also four Drakes that's going to become an Elder for AV if they lock this one down. That's a lot of power and a lot of time to work around not having Rhymeister. Seriously, rule number one is have vision in situations like this. Yeah, AV are playing a cheeky game. They're doing the exact same thing you are.
If they go to the Baron Pit right now, I think AV could probably almost three-shot it. That's three Mountain Drakes now with an Elder Drake buff on top.
And Paradise can destroy Raps.
Oh, yeah.
The problem is, I don't think Sin can actually contest this. Their best case scenario is Juve stealing it again. That's all they've got, and doing that means certain death for him, and it'll be a 4v5 again, where they would have an Elder Dragon still.
Oh, Paradise can't quite take down the ward.
He just starts
off the Baron. And look at this, they're doing so much damage to it. Everyone's going to turn up. Juves once again looking for the Wonder Steal as they are going to stop. Juves maybe in this pit a little bit too quickly as the Stand United's there. Is Squiggle going to get in? He is, but the Baron falls down. Triple grabs the kill onto Juves. That is one of the Sing tanks dead, and you can see now AV, Elder Drake buff, Baron buff, they are set up to win this game now.
Yeah, they have everything that they need and more. Sin find a way into this game miraculously, but AV pull it back. Now they can work through that bottom lane inhibitor with the Baron minions to boot. Sin, 4v5 is the name of the game against an Elder Drake enemy, and they have a lot of time remaining on that buff still. This is tough.
Yeah, Sin definitely have their work cut out for them now. Juves is up in 14 seconds. That is pretty quick. He can go for some sort of flank, but doesn't have a lot of tunnels out as Rhymeister is going to get caught. Fantastic gravity field comes up as well as Rhymeister now
Rhymeister.
Can set up the fight. Look at Chenny Boy taking so much damage. Squiggle as well. He's going to fall extraordinarily low and going to die. Of course, Paradise now just looking for the flanking play. And when there's a Nexus there to kill, that is the one that you want to take down. As how did he not die with five people on top of him? Make that four, of course. Counter-Strike is a pretty powerful ability, ladies and gentlemen. Do not underestimate it, and Paradise just ends the game.
What a really unusual way to end that game. I think that ending
we
actually
said abrupt.
Yeah, summarizes the entirety of that game. AV had control from start to finish. Eventually,
yep.
The Jax was going to scale, yeah, but Sin, they brought it back.
They most certainly did. So, with that, we have a tied series, and we're going to throw it back to the analyst desk to break down that game.
Thank you very much, Atlas and Russin. They're absolutely right. We have a series on our hands, guys. It's tied up 1-1 right now between Sin and Avant. But one thing hasn't changed between Game 1 and Game 2. Avant still have a very strong early game with great vision and great map control.
Yeah, it was phenomenal. They looked like they were just going to win out of early game, right? Mm. Jax gets really far ahead. Everyone else does well. I think everyone but Chenny was winning in CS, I remember correctly.
Yeah.
And when you can do that, that's great. That's amazing. They even stole the red in the invade. Like, cheesy, worked out well, right? But they just fell apart again. And at least they brought it back this time.
Yeah, and Avant really, like, as you mentioned, they played their waves extremely well. Whenever they had a wave pushing in on their top lane, on their bot side or their top lane, they're looking to invade, they're looking to rotate. That was incredible. And they were playing, and I guess we can really talk about their waves, right?
Yeah, we certainly can. I think one thing we can really pull up now, which will be up on your screen shortly, is the difference between CS between Jax and Shen in that match. And it's something we touched on before the broadcast as well, has a huge contrast between the two top laners. But once again, Avant coming out on top really early on.
Yeah, it takes him 5 minutes to get a 60 CS lead. That's amazing. That's 5 minutes of Shen probably not even CSing. And I don't attribute that just to Squiggle. That can't just be his fault, right? His team has to be saying, you need to be here, you need to be here, and just pulling around where he can't be, and other team members are taking the farm. Mm. But to get up 60 CS is huge, especially in a lane where Jax is a carry, he's a scaling carry, and Shen is this guy that does well because of his kit, not his items.
Yeah.
Keep in mind, he did great. He kept it at that 60 CS, so he sort of cauterized the wound, right? But that's a huge lead to give to a scaling champion.
And it's all about priority, like you're saying. Pretty much like Avant, how they play towards Paradise, they give him the waves every wave. And on top of that, they freeze for him. They, like, whenever he's pushing like massive waves, they look to deny for Shen. And then Shen is always, like, as you're saying, he's rotating. He really, and on top of that, they're prioritizing waves to Kassadin, where he gets pushed off a wave and then Kassadin TPs on. And it's just like, it just snowballs.
I hated that TP.
That was something.
But once again, in game number two, you know, Sin fight back throughout the mid game there. And Baron and Avant don't quite work out. We see a steal coming out from Juice once again, taking that one away. But it's what I really want to touch on is the lead that Sin got after they stole the Baron, after they got a couple of team fights, just didn't quite work out for them. We have a replay that we're going to bring up in just a second to show you guys an example of this. When Sin tried to finish the game for the second time, this is the second time they were on the Nexus and they couldn't close the game out.
Yeah, you're pushing through. And like, honestly, Shen has GA. They should just finish it. They should just end it. But then here's the question. Where's Kassadin? Kassadin's, wait, it's through. Yeah, he's going in. But yeah, this game's been a fiesta through and through, honestly, because they can just finish off the game. Shen has GA, as I mentioned earlier. He can be a lot more aggressive. He can look to, like, if he pops GA, that's fine. They should play around him.
I don't know. First things first, I blame you for bringing this Baron stuff here. We were amazing at Barons. Don't let anyone tell you anything. We were all amazing, especially us. And then you, with your fancy dress sense and your horrible Baron calls, come here and mess everything up.
It's the invasion.
But
Baron invasion.
I just don't know. I just don't know what Sim were doing wrong. Like they had this horrible early game. Mm. They dragged themselves back into this game in a game they have no right being in. And then something falls apart in the late game that looked a lot better in the first game than in the second.
Something I must point in is that, like, the Kassadin picks that have come out in both games, where first one, like the first game, it was pretty much, they can capitalize off of Baron mistakes. The second game where they're capitalizing of them staying too, like, just staying for the inhib on bot lane, right? Whenever they make a mistake, whenever they make a minor mistake, it just snowballs from there. And there's something really nice about Kassadin.
Fair play to Avant, though. They were still able to pull it back, even though they had a great early game, you know, dropped it. And they still were able to pick up the victory against Sin. You know, their late game wasn't, you know, they were able to capitalize on the Sin mistakes, which got them back into the series. And hopefully we'll see more from their game three, I hope.
Yeah. The one thing I really loved is their dragon control. Mm. 3 mountain drakes on Jax, you can't handle that. Surely he's just going to shred everything he touches.
Yeah.
And that's something they picked up that was better than their first game. Their first game, they sort of let the dragons go. They didn't place huge priority on them. So the fact that they changed that, huge in my mind. I really loved their adaptation to this game.
Yeah, that was a point that you mentioned in game one, where you're pretty much like, if you can't really deal with those barons, right? You could have gotten 4 free dragons off that one. And they really pulled it back. They got the free dragons when they had the opportunity, and they just took it away from there.
Well, after a big back-and-forth game between Sin and Avant, they tied up the series 1-1. We'll be back in 3.5 for the third and final game of the series. Don't go anywhere.